Hello friends, I'm Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to cover these topics which are listed in front of you. So we will see how we can set default landing page in Salesforce, whether it will be app or setup. Then I will tell you enhanced view of profile, then how we can enable login button, then setup audit trails, email deliverability, and check available user license. So these are some key features that you need to know while working in Salesforce as a admin. Before starting the demonstration, I just want to share one information. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, so you can go to description of this video and you will find links of various playlists available there. So now moving to first option. So our first option is default landing page. So how you can set that? So you need to click on this button available on top right corner and you can click on settings. From here, you can search for display and layout and customize my page. So here, this option is available, make setup my default landing page. So if this checkbox is enabled, so setup will be the default landing page. Otherwise, whatever app you have chosen, that will be open by default. So let me log out. Now I'm logging in. So here you can see a setup is selected. So my default landing page will be set up. Here you can see. Now if I uncheck this, save this. So I need to refresh this because I re-logged in. So I'm unchecking this, clicking on save, log out. So this time you will see setup won't be available. A particular application, which is default app, will be available. Here you can see, right? So this way you can set which will be your default landing page. So I am so if you are a normal user, then you can choose app as default. If you are admin or system administrator, then maybe you can choose setup as default landing page so that you don't need to open setup by clicking on the setup button. So this totally depends upon your requirements. Now, enhanced view of profiles. So this is also important. So whenever you open a profile, so sometimes we see detailed view of profile. So let me open a particular profile. So if I open this custom sales profile, so right now you are seeing detailed view. You need to scroll and then you will move to each and every option. So in user management setting, we have one more option available, enhanced profile view interface. So if I enable this and then if I search for the profile, so this time if I open a particular profile, so you will see enhanced view of profile like this. So all the headings are available here and whatever you want to update or change, you can select accordingly. So let's say I want to change object setting. So I can click on that option and all the objects will be available here. So this is enhanced view of profile so that you can apply through user management setting. Then enable login button. So sometimes when you are logged in as a system admin and you want to test something by logging in with a particular user. So if you don't know the username, sorry, if you don't know the password of that user, so you need like, you want to log in as that particular user. So you can enable login button if you are system admin. So you can type login. So here one option is available, login access policies. And here we have this option. Administrator can log in as any user. So if we enable this option, then we don't require any password to log in as a user. So you can log in as any user. So now if I see the list of users, so login button will be available in front of the user through which I can log in, right? So if I click on this login, so you will see here, I am logged in as a Vikas Gupta user, right? So I can easily log out from this. So this way you can enable login button before the user records so that as a system admin, you can log in with any user. So if you are working as a QA or after building something, you want to test it with a particular user. So this option is pretty required. Then set up audit trails. So sometimes what happens, some admin or user changes something and you are unable to figure out like who did what change. So here you can see in view setup audit trails, you can see each and every activity that is happening in the org. So right now you can see I logged in as a Vikas Gupta user. So this is my email ID because I am working as a system admin. So I logged in as a Vikas Gupta and then logged out. So each and every activity is tracked here, right? Then I changed administrator can log in as any user. So this setting I enabled. So whatever changes or whatever implementation in your org is happening, so you can track it and which user did what changes. So you can track that in your org, right? Now, so this setup audit trails option is covered. Now email deliverability. So for this, you can search for email, then deliverability option is available. So here you can see the option. So access to send email, all email services. So access level, all email, no access or system emails only. So from here, you can change this setting. Then check available user licenses. So for this, you need to search for users. So in every org, we have a limited number of licenses. So if you click on this add multiple users, so here you can see number of available licenses are displayed here. So this way you can identify like how many users for related to a particular license you can create. So you can see them here. So this way, I hope this video is helpful if you are a Salesforce person. So you need to know all these necessary things because in development or in testing, we normally need all these knowledge. So I hope this video will help you out. And if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and you will find links of various playlists available there. Thank you for watching this video.